Hello students, now we are discussing the experiment of computer network subject is related to simulate and understanding IP forwarding within a LAN and across a router. So first we will see the concept of IP forwarding, because IP forwarding is also known as internet routing is a process used to determine which path a packet or datagram can be sent. The process uses routing information to make decisions and is designed to send a packet over multiple networks. Generally, networks are separated from each other by routers. So IP routing is nothing but what? So network is nothing but internet which is connected to each other via routers. So routers can carry traffic from one network or one subnet to another. Routers maintain a routing table to decide how to route the IP packet. So each routing entry consists of the destination address, subnet mask and route to field. When a message needs to be routed to an IP address, it will perform the basically few steps. Those are nothing but the destination IP address is masked with the subnet mask and then compared with the destination field of all the entries in routing table. This comparison may yield match with more than one entry. The entry with longest subnet mask will be selected. For example, if packet is destinated from 192.168.1.2 reaching host A would match the corresponding entries to 192.168.1.2 and then the entry corresponding will be selected as its longer subnet mask. So once an entry has been selected, the route to field is consulted and the action taken depends on the contents of the field. So let us see how we first design this experiment. So first, here I am using the Cisco packet tracer simulation tools for performing the experiments. So in that devices, some inbuilt network devices are available. In that first we have chosen these end devices. So end devices in that first is taken the PCs, because PCs are required for the establishing the networks. Then take a switch devices. Then router, this is the router devices. So using these end devices, first we take the devices. Then using these connections, straight automatically chosen connection type, first we have made the connection line between machines to switch, then routers, and then this is the PC345 to second switch and then router. So this is PC012. It is called as a one network and PC345 is called as another network. So first PC0132 is connected to first switch and PC345 is connected to the another switch, and both switch are connected to the routing to traffic, means it is basically carry the traffic from one network to the another network. Okay, so first we can set the properties of routers. So routers, we can right click and select the config option. In that config, select fast ethernet 00, where we can set the IP address as 192.168.10.1 and subnet mask is 255.255.255.0, and port status should be selected is on. This is 00, fast ethernet is for first network, and for second LAN, that is PC345, we can set the IP address 01, it is nothing but 192.168.11.1. Subnet mask is 255.255.255.0 and status is on. So after setting the router config, we will next to check the IP addresses. So we can click on PC0 desktop. In that IP configuration table, we have select the static option IP configuration. We have give the IP address to first machine, that is 192.168.10.2, and the default gateway, that is nothing but the fast ethernet 00 address of the router, is given to the first LAN, that is nothing but 192.168.10.1. So same for second machine, go to the desktop option IP configuration, assign the IP address for PC1, that is 192.168.10.3. We can series create the series for 10 as a first network LAN, and default gateway is again given to the 10.1, and it is same for PC2 also. It is assigned IP configuration 10.4, subnet mask 255.255.255.0, default gateway is 192.168.10.1. Okay, so same way we can set all the IP addresses for the PCs related to the first network, that is 0, 1 and 2. Then we can set the IP addresses in another LAN machine, that is nothing but 3, 4 and 5. So 3, we can choose desktop IP configuration. Here we can set the IP address 192.168.10.2, because here we can give the IP address for first Ethernet 0 and as is 11. So default gateway is default route for the router for this machine is 11.1 and the IP address for the machine is 11.2. So PC4 is same desktop IP configuration, IP address 192.168.11.3, subnet mask 255.255.255.0 and default gateway is 192.168.11.1. And same for PC5 desktop IP configuration 192.168.11.4, subnet mask 255.255.255.0, default gateway 192.168.11.1. So after setting all the configurations related to the desktop machine and router, here we need to send the packets from host in first LAN to the host in another LAN. We can say the host A is a first PC012 and host B is called as a PC3, 4 and 5. So some steps are followed to router send the IP packets from host A to host B. So router can receive the Ethernet frame and passes it to IP layer. This is the first step. Second, IP routing table is consulted and matching entries found corresponding to the subnet. Packet is routed in second LAN. Host B MAC address is found from the ARP cache and Ethernet frame is addressed to host MAC address. So application sends a message, that is nothing but packets, to host B by sending its IP address. The IP address matches the entry corresponding. The root field for the selected entry contains from the IP address, because we can send the IP address from PC0 to PC5. So IP routing table is accessed again, this 192.168.10.1. The entry that matches contains LAN 1 interface ID. This specifies that destination node is directly connected to the host. The packet is passed over the device driver, that is switch and router. Through this, device drivers consult the ARP cache to identify the Ethernet MAC address corresponding to 192.168.10.1 and it is converted to another device driver. Ethernet frame is sent to MAC address founded by ARP. So let us see how packets are transmitted from one host A to host B. First we can choose a packet and set the path, that is PC0 to PC5. Then we can go to the simulation mode and start auto capture play. So it will be started to transmitting the packets from host A to the particular devices, that is switch and router. Then router can send the packets to switch, then switch is passed to the packet 5. Again it go to the router. Leak, it will show, router can show the information. Fast Ethernet 0.1. Okay, so in this way packets are receiving and transmitting successfully through the forwarding within a LAN and across a router. So let us see if we click here. So here they have shown the inbound PDU details and outbound layer 1 and 2 Ethernet header. So inbound PDUs, we can see the details of IP forwarding table. This table can shows the checksum IDs, then source IP, destination and destination IP address is what. So in this way it will work. Thank you.